y'all, Surfing Sapo here. Today is December 6th, 2012. Man, it went by fast, didn't it? World's gonna end anyway.
Yeah, right.
I don't think it says that. Society is what it is. Anyway, let's talk about fun stuff. Food, okay? I've been doing a lot of fishing lately, catching these fish called Pompanos, all right? Well, we usually smoke them, bake them. I've been wanting to try different styles, and I don't want to fillet them anymore. I want to cook the whole body, so I dressed them out, cut the heads off, froze the heads for making Filipino soup later, and I dressed these bodies out. And I'm going to try this frita style, Indian style, PompFret. Have you heard of it? I haven't, but I've been researching it. So back here, down there, you can't see it. I'm going to show you in a minute. I bought me on Black Friday a deep freeze. So man, I'm stocking up on fish, pork butts, TV dinners, you name it. So let's go ahead and look inside this little treasure trove and see what we can find, okay? All right, this is my tiny freezer. Wow, yum, yum. Look at all the goodies. Can you see down in there? Down here, bait shrimp. I keep my bait in here. But I've been freezing these pomps up like this. Check it out. Isn't that cool? This is a food saver. There's no air in here, just bodies. This is a dressed up pomp. Cut the head off. Cut the fins, the tail, gut and gillet, just pure meat. So I'm going to thaw these out, then we'll get started, okay? All right, here they are. They've been thawed out, so I'm just going to cut this bag open. See all the blood? We're going to wash them even better. Cut the bag open, dump them in the sink, cold water. You can even wash the bag out so it don't stink so bad in the garbage. Throw that to the side and just wash them. Pretty much clean them. I already gut them. They got a little bit of blood inside. Who cares? We ain't gonna eat that. Get them pretty clean like this. There you go. Drain it. Let that ugly blood go down. Okay. There we have it. See? Nice pompanos. So we'll take them over to the preparation table. We'll start prepping them out. I decided I'm gonna, well, hold on. I'm gonna show you what I decided.
All right.
Be right back. I got four of these and I got four spices. We're gonna start off with Slap Your Mama. That's gonna be the Cajun Pompano. Cavender's Greek Seasoning, that's gonna be the Greek Pompano. Whatever this is, Taste of India. Hot Relish, Hot Mango Relish, that's going to be the Indian Pompano. And then Walker's Wood Jerk, Jamaican Jerk Seasoning, this is good stuff, real hot. That's going to be the Yaman Pompano. So, first thing we got to do is get a Chang knife. Chang knife, remember Chang? Yeah, he's on holiday right now. Get a Chang knife, make sure, very sharp Chang knife. Okay, Chang knife sharp. You see how sharp it is? Let me show you. No, I'm just kidding. Cut, angle. See? That's how you can tell it's sharp. Just cuts through it like if it was somebody's finger. Like that. And then we go this way. Down to the bones. Now you notice we have diamonds. We're going to do the same to the other side, then I'll be back. We'll put on our garnish. Not garnish, what am I saying? Spices. Da-da-da.
All right, we're
going to do the Cajun one first. I got the Slap Your Mama's Louisiana hot sauce here. We're just going to put that on it. Let it get inside all the cracks, holes, crevices, whatever you want to call them. You know, It's like when you do the catfish. Then, like I told you before, you go to Morgan Street Seafood Market in Corpus Christi, Texas, and he has all the different ones of this. This is the white pepper blend. I'm going to put that on. Okay. Rub it in. Get it. Main parts are get it in these holes. Cracks. Crevices. There we go. All right. Let's do the other side. Get in there. Wipe fingers off. Put some more. Remember, this stuff's real salty. It's okay. It's hot, too. Hot is good. All right. We'll let it sit there for a bit. We'll do the other ones. You pretty much know what I'm going to do, except I'm going to put these on it, different spices. All right, the different ones. And then we'll proceed, because it's going to take too long if I do every single one on camera. You get the point, though. So let me go ahead and I got to do one more thing to this. I just need to get the ingredients. I'll be right back. All right, we're back. What we do here, put the lid back on this first. Got some cornmeal, seasoned cornmeal, whatever you got. You can use flour too. Don't matter. I'll cut through there. Oh well, that's going to cook fast then. Just kind of get a little bit all over the sucker. Try. I'm just not going to put it inside the cracks, the cornbread, cornmeal that is. Put a little bit over here. Anyway, you're just more or less giving it something to crisp up on. That way the skin, the bitter pompano skin, will be edible. There you go. You see that? Is that cool? All right. Now we'll proceed over to the wok. Heating up the oil. Be right back. All right, folks. Here goes nothing. We're going to take the pomp here, and we're going to lay it in this oil. That oil's pretty hot now, I think. I don't want it like crazy hot either. There we go. Take a gander at that. We're going to cook it for about maybe 5 to 8 minutes on each side. So I'll see you in a bit. I gotta get Porky. This is Porky, by the way. See Porky? He's a timer. So I'm gonna set Porky and I'll see you in a bit. Coming along quite well. Been, let me see. Been about 5 minutes. 5 more minutes and we'll flip it over. All right, it's time to flip it over. See if we can do this without killing ourselves. Oh, that's, look at that. That's beautiful, folks. That is beautiful. Can you see that? Look at this. Oh, man, nice and hard. The chicharrones of the pompano. See the slits? I think we got a keeper here, this recipe. This is the Cajun one. We still have the Greek, the Indian, and the Jamaican one to do. But y'all get the point, right? You want to see me do one more, that's fine. I'll do the last one. The next one up is the Greek one, but I'll do the Jamaican jerk one at the end for y'all to see. Alright. Alright. It's finished. Now to gently, simply, whatever we want to call it, Lee, take it out. And we're going to set it over here. So follow me. All right, cheer. That's what we have so far. That's one. Now, I only saw, I think, one problem, and that's going to be, I'm going to be doing them all in the same oil, so it might interact with the spices. This will probably be the only one that doesn't have other fish flavor. Who cares? But look at that, man. I don't even want to, I'm going to let it rest, because I'll end up crunching into that, and y'all ain't going to see nothing. Let me do these other three, and on the last one, I'm going to let you see. All right, we'll be back. The Greek one's done now. Let's go ahead and get it out of the chair. There we go. See it? So we'll carry on to the next.
Alright.
Here comes the Indian one. When I say Indian, I mean like Pompeii. Bombay, I'm sorry. It's Pompeii, that's Italy. Duh. Gotta kind of pick it up slow. There we go. There's the Indian one. And this is killer, yo. So set the timer and see you in a bit. I told you I wasn't gonna show you this, but it's so fun I had to show you. Alright, here. Is it, man, oh man, this one smells good. This is a hot mango relish that I've packed into the crevices. Man, that smells, the house smells like another, like Europe or something, all these different countries. Cajun, Greek, Jamaican, Indian. Oh man, good stuff, y'all.
All right, here comes,
flipping over the, Indian one. Oh man, that's lovely. Seems like the cornmeal gives it a better crust than the flour, but still quite lovely, let's say. Alright, we'll let this go for 10 minutes, and the last one's coming up. That's the Jamaican jerk one, and it does have cornmeal. So I'm thinking cornmeal from now on instead of flour. You see flour, you can see right through the skin. Whatever, it's my first time. I got plenty of Pompanos, so hope to get some more, but this is a killer way to make some snacks, you know. Just give everybody one of these and say that's all you get. So you take one little piece off each day. It should last, you know, last the person a couple weeks, and then you give them some milk. All right, Indian one's done. Omega-3 dripping out of there. See that, folks? Yum. Last but not least, the Jamaican jerk one. I think I cut too far through the... This piece is kind of dangling right there, but that'll be the tester then. Oh, yeah. Can you say lovely? Let's take a gander. That is just... killer. The house smells like no other smell that you've ever smelled around Corpus Christi. Usually all you smell is mesquite wood and burnt tortillas. But this smells good, y'all. Alright, we'll be back in 10 minutes and flip this and let it rest. And then we're going to taste every single piece and the skin. And we're going to give a honest opinion of this type of cooking. And I think I know it's good. I don't even think. I haven't tasted it. Pompano, you can't mess it up. Well, you can if you smoke it and don't cook it all the way. Anyway. Been there, done that. Alright, be back in a flash.
Alright.
Time to flip this baby over. Yeah, this one's... The meat might fall off, I hope not, but it might. Oh, it held on. Good boy. Like to talk to the food, you know. Anyway, this is really amazing cooking. Of course, I haven't tasted it, but I think it's going to be good, folks. Let me let this one finish, then rest just so I don't burn my palate. Then I'll get them prepped up on a plate. Well, I'm going to show you how they do it. I only know because I was checking it out. But this, I'm gonna prepare it, taste it, and if it's a keeper, it's a keeper. If it's not, then we'll go back to, you know, the classical style.
Alright.
Last one's done. See if we can get it out of there without busting that piece off. Yep, did it. Omega-3s drip out first. There you go, folks. Shut off the fire. Come on over here. There we go. That's the last one. So we'll let this rest now. And then we'll carry on to do our taste test. I always mess up when I say that, but I said it right that time. Taste test. Okay, see you in a bit. All right, we've got a little bit of everything here. Get me a paper towel. I'll get a fork to make it correct. Anyway, first right here is the Slap Your Mama, the Cajun one. Let's see what we can do here. Can you see that? I can't tell. I'm going to put the fork in there and just bust a piece out of there. There we go. Right here. The backbone right there. Let's see if we can get some more out of there. Just got to slide it. Let's try to slide it like this. There we go. There's the backbone. It's a piece right here. We'll get a piece of each. Set it on this paper towel. Then we'll test it at the end. Get out of there, dog. Dog's freaking out. I don't remember which one I did second. Oh, the Greek one. Yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah. Look at that, man. Oh, perfect little chunk of pomp. Greek. Cajun. Then we went over cheer to the, this one right here. Can you see that? Yeah. I'm having hard time, folks. So we'll take a chunk right out of the middle right here. Try to. There we go. Perfect. This is our Indian one. Put him right there. And then last but not least, the one we just did. Well, it's crunchy. Can't see the line. Hopefully it'll come out good. Yeah, there we go. Chunk. Walker Wood. Jerk. Since I'm a jerk, I made some jerk pomp. So we've got all the pieces right here. Right there. And I'm going to turn the camera around. We're going to have a taste test. All right?
All right, folks, we're done.
Thanks for following me through this process. Very kind of y'all. So, let's get our fish right here. You see that? Start off with the Cajun. Slap Your Mama. That is good, man. And by the way, the skin ain't bitter. It's crunchy. Man, that's killer. That is killer. Now we're on to the Greek. Jimmy the Greek. Remember him? Greek. Wait a minute. I think I got out of order. No, that's right. Oh, man. The flour did come out. The skin is killer, man. It's crunchy. This is fun and tasty. All right, this is the Indian one. Oh, man. Mango relish. Hot mango relish. Oh, man. That one is something. Those two combinations of the fish and that flavor, that's the best so far. Man, wow. And last but not least, Walker Wood Jamaican Jerk. Oh, another winner. Oh, the last two are the bomb. Oh, man. This ain't even funny. I think I'm going to eat those two pomps and leave the first two for my wife. Don't tell her. Oh, man. That's it. Ha. I don't know what to say, folks. The Jamaican jerk one's the best. Wow. That is unbelievable, man. It's kind of spicy, but it has that... You can taste that allspice just... Whoom! That is awesome. And the hot mango relish, I thought that was the best at first. But then come to find out, the Walker Wood is the best. So I got to stock up on that. The Greek one, maybe I should have put more. I don't know. It might have been that the oil took the seasoning away. It can do that. And Slap Your Mama, it's good. But those two are unbelievable. So it's been a success story. PompFret, Pompano. PompFret, I think it means fried. Pompano's the name of the fish. So PompFret, fish, fried fish, PompFret, Pompano, fried Pompano. And it's a keeper. Definitely a keeper. And we'll see you next time. God bless you. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. If I don't make any videos, I'm sorry. I'm trying to get back into it, but it has to come from my heart, okay? So y'all just hang in there. And this was from my heart, this one, by the way. I've been wanting to do this for a while. So thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, whatever you want to do. It's cool, man. If I delete you, I'm sorry. No, I'm kidding. It has to be something real bad. All right. See my eyes? There. Some guy says there's not enough light, so there you go. All right, man. God bless y'all. Bye. Peace out. Hasta luego. Adios. Auf Wiedersehen. All of the above.
Get to run.